Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us continue talking about lead and lag functions under windowing functions. As part of the previous topic, we have seen how to use lead or lag functions with the order by clause where the data is sorted in a particular order and we have got the following or preceding records. If you want to do the same thing within a key, we can use partition by clause as well. So first we partition the data by partition by clause and then sort the data using order by clause within over, and then we should be able to get the previous records or following records using lead or lag function. For the demonstration purpose, using partition by as well as order by clause, I will be using a different table called as daily product revenue. If you look at this table, there are three fields: order date, order item product ID, and revenue. We have created this table by joining orders and order items, and then we have filtered for complete or closed orders. Then we have grouped by order date and order item product ID. Using sum, we actually computed the revenue for each product for each day. You can actually select star from this table with the limit 10, and you should understand the data that is there in this table. For each and every date, there's a product ID and the revenue generated by that product. Now let's say for each and every date, I want to get the top performing product and then the next top performing product in the same row. Then I can use lead function. As I am trying to define the top performance by the highest amount of revenue, if I use lead function, I have to sort the data in descending order by revenue. If I use lag function, I can sort the data in ascending order by revenue and we should be able to get the same results. So let me write the query and then we will take it further. Here I am saying select t dot star. T will be the alias for daily product revenue when we define it in from clause. And then lead of order item product ID over partition by order date, because we are trying to get within each date, and then order by revenue DESC. Let me give the alias as next order item product ID, then lead of revenue over, then the criteria is same, partition by order date and order by revenue descending, next underscore revenue from daily product revenue T limit 100 and hit enter. You can see the results here. On 2013 July 25th, the top performing product is 1004. And the revenue generated by that product is nothing but $5,599.72. The next top performing product is nothing but 191. Revenue generated by that is $5,099.49. Then the second one is 191 and $5,099.49, which is same as this. For that, the next product is 957. Revenue generated by that is $4,499.70. If you scroll down, the last record within the date 2013 July 25th have null values with respect to the date and revenue. If you want to replace these nulls with zeros, then we can actually specify the third argument as zero, especially with respect to the revenue, and then we should be able to get the revenue to be zero. Also, if you want to get two records following or three records following, as part of the second argument, you can actually say two or three, and you should be able to get the two records following or three records following, etc. By default, if you just pass one argument as part of the lead function, it will consider as only one record following or one record preceding. So let us try to replace the nulls with zeros. As we have to pass the third argument to replace the nulls with zeros, this lead has to be changed to lead of revenue comma 1 comma 0. Then it will try to get one record following, and if there is a null value in that, it will be replaced with 0. So to write the query, I can copy paste from here to here. And then I have to say lead order, not order underscore revenue, it's only lead revenue, comma 1, comma 0. This one is to get the one following record, and then over, and then we can copy paste the rest of the query. Then you can say limit 100 and hit enter. While the query is running, you can actually review the query once again. As part of the first lead function where we are applying on order item product ID, we are not trying to overwrite any null values, and hence within the key, the last record will contain null for odd item product ID. But with respect to revenue, as we are trying to replace the nulls with zeros, the last record within the key will have zero for the revenue. That being said, the query have returned the results. You can review the results here. For 2013 July 25th, the top performing product is 1004. The revenue generated by that product is nothing but $5,599.72. The next top performing product is nothing but 191, and the revenue generated by that product is approximately $5,100. And you can see the same numbers here. Like that, you see the rest of the records. With respect to the last record for 2013 July 25th, you can see that product ID is null, but the revenue is zero because we have overwritten the nulls with zeros in case of the revenue. Same is the case with 2013 July 26th or any other date. So this is how you should be able to use partition by clause to group the data within a key and then get the following or preceding records using lead or lag. If you have to replace the nulls with zeros, you have to pass the three arguments. The third argument has to be zero or whatever value you want to replace with. And the second argument has to be specified even if you have to get the immediate record as one. If you want to get some records prior or some records following, then you have to pass the second argument with that value. So at max, lead or lag takes three arguments. The first one is the column name. Second one is how many records you want to get following or preceding. And the third argument is nothing but what should be done with the null values.